So I think we want to close the session today with just focusing on the key questions around what are the migration drivers, right? So why to migrate? I think this is a question that we get often from customers in terms of why this is a priority or why it should be a priority for me, and would love to engage in that discussion.
Absolutely, because we've had lots of speakers this morning.
Yeah.
And I would love for you to really summarize our strategy and North Star for data and AI.
Okay. Yeah, so I think everything for us in terms of Azure data and AI strategy starts with digital transformation, right? So I think the ecosystem that we live in, that we operate in today, is connected by this intelligent cloud. And we have kind of computing power wherever it matters the most, wherever it requires. And it's this combination of, I think, the local computing power with a connected cloud that really is transforming and driving digital transformation for our customers. And at the center of it is, I think, a constant stream of data.
Yes.
Of exploding volumes, variety, velocity, and I think capturing and harnessing this data to and leveraging it as part of this intelligent cloud and intelligent edge, and applying intelligence on top of that data is really the key to unlocking digital transformation scenarios.
And especially real-time data scenarios.
Absolutely. I think we see companies of all sizes across all industries really transforming themselves by leveraging this stream of data as an asset. And I think the key to success from a digital transformation standpoint, we see them kind of driving intelligent customer experiences, transforming business models, empowering their employees, and optimizing operations, right? Mm-hmm. So in all aspects of their business, kind of leveraging this power of the intelligent cloud, the intelligent edge with data asset at the center. So I would summarize our strategy and our North Star from a Azure data perspective as simply enabling our customers' digital transformation through leveraging and harnessing this data as an asset and applying intelligence on top of it to unlock the digital scenarios for them.
I see. All right, let's talk from the customer perspective, please.
Yeah. So I think, we get often the question of kind of why to migrate and why to modernize. And
yes.
I want to kind of approach this from a customer perspective. There's been discussions in the past about the end of support benefits on Azure, and is that the reason I should migrate?
Yeah.
I think while those are tremendous and definitely a great offering from us at Microsoft to help customers navigate the end of support, what we've seen in all our customer engagements is really kind of three key categories and three types of drivers for modernization and migration. The first is kind of what we just talked about, which is connecting to digital transformation.
Yeah.
I think it's hard, if not impossible, really to do all the digital transformation scenarios that companies aspire to do if your data is locked up in a legacy platform. So I think modernizing and managing that data in a modern platform is fundamental to unlocking kind of the digital transformation scenarios and applying the power of cloud data and AI, which is key to digital transformation. So that's one primary driver, I would say, for why customers modernize.
Yeah.
The second is kind of security and risk mitigation. So as the data volumes and velocity and variety have exploded, so have the security threats, right? I think the bad guys are constantly innovating. The regulations are coming by the day, whether it's GDPR or anything else. And all of this kind of creates complexity for our customers and the need to really manage their data in a way that keeps them secure, keeps them compliant, and do it at a scale that, frankly, is hard to do on premises.
Yes.
And requires the power of the cloud to manage it efficiently and cost effectively. So that's a big driver that we've seen customers come to us basically and say they have this sprawling data estate that's getting very cost ineffective and expensive and inefficient to manage security with. So I think moving into the cloud is a big driver for that. And last but not least is cost. I mean, I think cost is always critical and key in the business world. What I've seen here is customers really looking at cost savings derived from data migration as the fuel to fund their digital transformation projects and priorities. So I think taking all the tier two, tier three databases or applications, for example, and kind of automating, outsourcing that to a fully managed service in the cloud generates a tremendous amount of savings in total TCO that can then be redirected to your digital transformation priorities. And I think we've seen that as another key pattern. So I think at the end of the day, it is, like I said, all about digital transformation for every company. And it's using the power of cloud data and AI and specifically optimizing security and costs to drive the digital transformation that we've seen as a key driver for migration.
I see. So I know that customers and partners, including myself, by the way, are more interested in implementing new and exciting projects, right? Connected
Absolutely.
To innovation. Innovation is always, super exciting. And not like boring migration of existing capabilities from on-prem to the cloud. Is this prioritization incorrect? Is this excitement incorrect?
No, I think it's spot on, actually. Okay. I mean, I think we want to, from Microsoft's perspective, talk about and help customers and engage with customers on innovation as well. I think it's important to kind of look at migration as a foundational step to innovation. We migrate to innovate,
yes.
right? We don't migrate for the sake of migration.
Yeah.
I think as Microsoft, we don't kind of recommend migration and just kind of leaving it there. I think there is always a connection back to digital transformation priorities and the need to innovate. And that's key. I think in Komats, I think that we see that all across the board with customers that have kind of engaged in migration projects with us. And Komatsu is a great example, one of the largest construction companies based in Japan,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
is betting on Azure as
yeah.
their platform for IoT and data and AI.
Yeah.
And really, it started with this driver of saying, how do we optimize our operations to drive the digital transformation initiatives. And they chose Azure and specifically SQL Database Managed Instance for a couple of reasons, right? I think the first is kind of the basic or the foundational, the fundamental kind of reach and capability of Azure infrastructure. I think it offered a lot of scale, out-of-the-box compliance in Japan and their local markets and local needs, as well as kind of efficiency in provisioning and everything else that they were not able to match anywhere else. In fact, they had the system up and running within 2 months, I believe. And then second big driver was this promise of provided by the SQL Database Managed Instance, right? Which is applying a lift and shift type effort, but getting a fully managed PaaS service result. I think the combination of that is extremely compelling for Komatsu and for other customers who frequently kind of have thought about achieving kind of the fully managed service as a expensive, complex, lots of rewrite and re-architecture type of proposition. And I think with Managed Instance, they were able to literally apply kind of a lift and shift type effort and get significant cost savings. I think it was around 49% cost savings that they received, as well as a 25 to 30% performance improvement.
I see. So in conclusion, you first migrate, and then that makes innovation easier.
Yeah, I think innovation is always the North Star. I think for our customers, for us as Microsoft, we want to drive innovation. But as I said, I think migration is a foundational step in that journey. And it's important to think about the migration projects from that perspective and prioritize accordingly.
Fantastic. So any closing guidance and call to action for us?
Yeah. So I think in summary, I mean, I think it's, again, I would emphasize kind of the connecting the need for migration to your digital transformation priorities, right? It's not about migration for the sake of migration or even for the sake of kind of leveraging cool new technologies in the cloud. It's really kind of what that does for the business and for the digital transformation priorities. So, you know, I would, my Uber message here would be think big in terms of why to migrate, but start small, right? All of our customers that we've seen successful in this journey have started with a handful of applications and databases. Don't try to solve for the entire estate and for your entire IT environment in one shot. I think if you pick the high priority applications and databases that can yield the most impact and start with migrating those, you'll create momentum for yourself, for your staff, and for the business that will then kind of feed itself and move forward. So visit the Azure Migration Center. I think we, besides all the great platform offerings we have on Azure, we have some of the best tools and resources to help you with migration. And Azure Migration Center is the best place to start, along with kind of the step-by-step how to migrate guidance available at datamigration.microsoft.com. And last but not least, I think Dharmadi just spoke about it in the previous session, make sure we maximize and leverage the Azure Migration Program. It's really a tremendous way to get skilling assistance, to get assistance in setting up the foundational Azure environment that you need for long-term success, as well as jumpstarting your, you know, initial set of applications and databases at no cost to the customer. So I think it's a great offering and encourage everybody to leverage that to jumpstart your journey.
Wow, thank you so much, Pradeep. That was great information.
All right.
And a great way to finish the show.
Great, thanks, Sanjay. Thank you, everybody.